pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Hear us, Almighty God, and having instilled in your servants the teaching of the Christian faith, graciously purify them by the working of this sacrifice through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift, each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feast with the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and on the works of charity, and by participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may lead to faithfulness of grace that you bestow upon your sons and daughters. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. He said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Oh,
forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Hilton, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we are life and failing health. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Mark, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you gave to your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summon before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour be yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At our Saviour's command and taught by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who says to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of his Lamb.
Glory to the Lord, and worthy that you should enter under my roof. For only save the world, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Thank you. gift aid envelopes at the back of the church. Please take your envelopes, but don't start using them until you've used up the envelopes in your old box, so that it starts a new financial year. I think that's about all anything. Oh, Lent and Family Fast collections. Congratulations on your generosity across all the parishes. You raised £1,500. That includes the gift aid. So thank you for that effort. Up and coming event, St. Ildefus, the 19th of April, a quiz night with a taco bar, entry £10, free cocktail. Also, I'd like to thank everybody who worked so hard. We had a marvellous St. Patrick's night. We really toasted this feast. And thank you very much for all the support and the people who worked so hard and who came to that event as well. One other thing, there will be Stations of the Cross, and it will be here in St. Ildefus at 7 o'clock on Friday. Okay, so that's a good thing. See if there's something else I've missed out. You just say the prayer, it's not in your newsletter, but I'll say the prayer anyway for the Ukraine. Mary, Our Lady of God, Mother of God, we ask you to intercede for the people of Ukraine, for the world, for their government and all who suffer as a result of war. Be with them as you stood beside your son as they suffered on the cross of Calvary. Give them strength and courage through faith, hope, and justice. May we in our turn support them through prayer and generosity, that human lives may be saved, that the injured may be healed, that the dead may rest in peace, and there be peace after war. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go in peace, the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.